Hello, students and parents. Hope you're doing well. We are going to start testing your ability to be able to write complete sentences, both mapping sentences and writing complete sentences using prepositional and verb phrases and identifying the subject and predicate part of sentences. So this is an example of the test sheet that is in your packet. If you would like to review and write down the portion of the video that pertains to that example that's at the top. This is the video for doing that. And then continue on with the rest of the test. I hope all of you do really well and try and write very good sentences using verb phrases and prepositions. You have your worksheets at home. Hopefully you can find one around. I might put one in the package for you, just loosely, not with it. And try and write as complete a sentence as you can. Don't forget your capitals and periods. Here's a test we're going to have on mapping and writing complete sentences using subject, predicates, prepositions, and verb phrases, auxiliary and main verbs. I know that sounds like a lot, and the instructions are quite long, but I'm going to give you a sample here, like we've done on each one of these sheets. But this is going to be a test in this particular case. Okay. So I want you to, hopefully you've had enough practice with these that you're going to be able to both map and write complete sentences using subject predicate, prepositional phrases, prepositional and verb phrases, and of course having our auxiliary and main verbs. That makes up our verb phrase. Let me go ahead and read the instructions. Map the sentences below and then create three original sentences of your own. Here's five you map, three originals. Include all three parts of the sentence structure, subject, predicate, prepositions. Put a P and a noun when you're mapping for their nouns. Circle a prepositional phrase. That's the preposition plus the noun. Identify the helping and main verbs, okay, with a V, and then underline the verb phrase. So let's give you an example here, and then I'll write an original sentence here, and then I want you to complete 1 through 5 and A, B, and C below. My sister should have been waiting for me near the car. Okay, and you can do this again in any order. I'm going to say near the car. I know this is a preposition and a car is a noun because nouns are things we can see. And this shows the position of the car. Okay. And where my sister should have been waiting. So here's my preposition. For is also a preposition in me. I can see myself, at least if I look in a mirror. So here's my preposition and here's my noun. And there's my prepositional phrase. Now, what action is actually occurring here? You can say, well, someone's waiting for somebody. So waiting is our main verb. And are there some helping verbs that go with waiting? I can look over here and say, my sister. Okay, well, a sister is a noun, so that's going to be the subject. The subject of a sentence is always a noun. And I can see that should have been waiting. If you have a worksheet that you have lying around the house, you will see that should have been waiting. These are all helping verbs. And you're going to underline all the verbs, the helping verb plus the main verb. This we can put as main verb. You don't have to put M there, but just recognize that all these verbs are connected together and that this is our verb phrase. Okay? This is our verb phrase. We're going to underline it and define it. Now, sister is our subject. So here is who in the sentence. And this is all the action that's occurring after this. So we separate our subject from everything that's occurring. And this one is complete now. It has been completely mapped. It's a complete sentence, has a capital, has a period. Now I'm going to come up with my own sentence. I'm going to say, let's see, my neighbor's dog's name is Daisy. Daisy was stuck between the fence. This happened this morning. And the stairs. So this one has two nouns. It has a fence and a stair. So this one's a little bit crazy. This is just the one that kind of came to my head. So between is a preposition, but this one has two nouns. I don't think there's other examples down here that are like this. This has the fence and the stairs. So this is kind of a compound noun right here because she's between two things. So I have to say what two things she's between. That's the, when you use a preposition between, you have to identify what two things something's between, and that gives you two nouns over here. Was, Daisy's the one doing the action, so here's our subject. She was stuck. Here's our main verb, here's our helping verb, and since she's the one doing the action and she was the one that was stuck, this completes mapping out this whole sentence. So here's a sample for you. When you write out your sentence here and you don't have a helping verb or you don't have a preposition in it, you have to add that to it. Make sure you use your prepositions and your helping verbs. That's what we're practicing in fourth grade. All right, good luck with your test. Take your time with it, and I hope you do well.